Warning, the following video that you're about to see contains bad language and is only recommended for ages 13 and over. No kids under the age of 13 allowed. Viewer discretion is advised. So if you're a kid under the age of 13, then you better get your ass off this damn video right now. Because Spearder21's channel is not for you.
Yeah, exactly. He's a piece of shit. And him saying that at least Lil Nas X isn't overrated. Like, motherfucker, he is overrated. Old Town Road is one of the worst songs I've ever heard. It's fucking garbage. The original and the remix with Billy Ray Cyrus are both garbage. And what's so special about Lil Nas X? He's a ripoff of Nas by stealing his stage name. An original motherfucker, just like Taylor Swift and Olivia Rodrigo. I just don't get what's so special about the artist that he likes. He just likes garbage music artists, but yet he gets all mad when we criticize them and speak nothing but 100% facts about the artist that he likes. It's like it's the truth, motherfucker. Handle it. Be a man and shut the fuck up, you know? It is true, Taylor Swift does make music about exes in the majority of her music. And yet he still wants to make videos about us saying, oh, they haven't heard all of her music because this song and this song and this song and this song isn't about a breakup or an ex, it's about this, it's about that. It's like, shut the fuck up, dude. Shut the fuck up. Just a fucking psychotic stan who doesn't know and shut the fuck up.
Yeah, exactly, man. And the nerve of him to put Lil Nas X in the same sentence as Eminem, Tupac, and Biggie. Like, are you kidding me? Eminem and Tupac especially influenced a lot of artists. I mean, if it wasn't for Eminem and Tupac, there's a lot of artists we wouldn't have. And he's just so fucking ignorant. And he has no respect for music at all. It's like, how fucking dare you put those three artists in the same category as Lil Nas X. Get the fuck out of here with that shit. You know? What a fucking joke. But yeah, man. Lil Nas X is trash and so is the Old Town Road song. I don't know. Maybe he's just saying that because I don't like him. You know? Let me just say the opposite. I don't know. Fucking, that guy is just stupid, man. Like, God, man. Yeah, exactly, man. He's so damn pathetic. You know, he likes so many garbage ass artists and yet he wants to talk all this shit about these good artists. It's like the gall of him. And you know, it's like I don't get his Taylor Swift art, Taylor Swift points. It's like even if she has a few songs that aren't about like breakups of exes, shouldn't it still be an issue that a majority of her music's about that? I mean, shouldn't that still be a complaint? I mean, come on. Like Whit Lowry, for example. That's a rapper that's all right, but a lot of people have criticism for him because he just makes so many relationship songs. And I've only heard like maybe a few fucking songs where he doesn't talk about that shit. But it still doesn't change the fact that the majority of it is about that, you know? Like, I think that's the point that you and others try to make about Taylor Swift, is the majority of her music's like that. But for some reason, Zach G's like, what about these few exceptions? Like, those are exceptions, not a rule. Majority of her music's about that. That's the problem, you know? Like, he's so fucking stupid, man. It's like he should know that himself. He's so damn obsessed with Swift. And he says, oh, I wouldn't have sex with her. I wouldn't do it. It's like, yeah, he would. That's why he's so fucking obsessed with her. That's why he's so into her. He would fuck her. He's lying out of his ass.
I know, right? Really pathetic and ridiculous to even mention Lil Nas X in the same sentence as Eminem, Tupac, and the Notorious B.I.G. because those rappers are actually legendary and actually put effort into their music. What's so special about Lil Nas X? Doesn't even put any effort into his music, and he has the devil in his music videos and all that crap. What's so special about that shit? Nothing. That's what I don't get about these fans of these modern rappers. Not all fans of modern rappers, but lots of them. If you don't like their music, they'll go and bash you and say, oh, the artist that you like is trash. Eminem's trash. Tupac's trash. Biggie's trash. Jay-Z is trash. Nas is trash. Ice Cube is trash. Snoop Dogg is trash. E-40 is trash. And so on and so forth. It's like, shut the fuck up. You don't even know what good rap music is. If you think Lil Nas X is better than Eminem, Pac, Biggie, Jay-Z, Ice Cube, Snoop Dogg, E-40, and other good rappers. So, it's like, shut the fuck up, man. He's not a good rapper, so I don't get what's so special about the dude, you know? And I'm not saying that because he's a gay rapper, no. I'm saying it because it's so damn true, you know? Just don't get the hype of these artists that he speaks of. Lil Nas X, Taylor Swift, Lil Rodrigo, and any other music artists that he thinks is so damn good when they're not. You know, it's just bullshit. Can't even have an opinion because this motherfucker just wants to make video after video after video after video and all this other retarded shit. It's like I haven't even made any videos in over a month, but yet this motherfucker still wants to talk shit about me over old videos, and because I buried his ass in a live stream the other night.
Yeah, man, exactly. I don't get why a lot of these modern rap fans will bash all these old school rappers. I don't even think they listen to their music. It's almost like they just bash it because it's old or something. They probably don't even check the music out. You know? It just seems stupid as hell to me, especially when, you know, a lot of these new school rappers they like wouldn't even be around if it weren't for the old school rappers. It's like, what's the disrespect about? But yeah, I don't get Zach G's issue, because like you said, you haven't made videos in a while, just that stream about him. And Zach G started all this shit. Started with TG Venom, then he worked his way down on everybody else, you know? And he ripped off Kadeem saying, I'm going to be dissing this dude. And he ripped off Spear Dude by, you know, Spear Dude does that thing in his videos where he, like, makes a mockery of certain people. Zach G was doing that in his video. Like, this dude rips everybody off. He's a retard. It's like, how is he going to sit there and lie about Flamehead and say that he needs to stop talking about Olivia Rodrigo and MGK and Taylor Swift? But don't even make videos about them anymore. When is the last time that he made a video about them? He don't even make videos about them. The last few videos have been about, like, Avril Lavigne's albums, and then one was about, like, a Q&A. Since when was the last time Bud made videos about those artists? Like, Zach G is a fucking... he's such a fucking idiot. It's like, dude, where are the videos that he's doing on him? Because I don't see him. The nerve of this dude to say that he has a diverse music taste. This motherfucker don't have a diverse music taste. All this fucking dude listens to is Taylor Swift and a few artists. He's a closed-minded fuck when it comes to rap music. He never truly was into rap music. He hates it for dumb reasons. He always flip-flop on rap. He ain't got no diverse music taste. Because he don't even give rap music a chance, you know? I remember that bullshit rant he did on rap back in the day. Dude ain't got no diverse taste. And he says that the Flame has just stopped talking shit about him. It's like, you talk shit about him. What the fuck are you talking about? You run your mouth about him, Zach G. Like, how are you going to get mad at him for responding when you keep fucking talking about him? Like, God, man. It's like everything he says, it's almost like he's talking about himself in a way when he says things. It's fucking stupid. And he's so just unaware of his own stupidity. Like, the nerve of him to say that there's nothing wrong with being obsessed with music artists. Has this guy not heard of situations that's happened? Like the weirdo that killed John, I forgot his name, the guy from the Beatles, shot him. I don't know if he was a fan or not. Then there was a guy that shot the guitarist of, I think, the guitarist of Pantera. And then there was that one girl. She was an up-and-coming star. She was an up-and-coming singer. I think she was on American Idol. An obsessive fan killed her. And yet he wants to sit here and say, there's nothing wrong with being up. It's like, shut the fuck up, motherfucker. Like, you don't know shit about shit. Because all you got all these obsessive fans out here that are not only weird to begin with, but you have certain obsessive fans that have took it too far. Like, how dare he even try to say that shit? Is he not aware of these scenarios where an obsessive fan's tried to kill someone they're obsessed with? You know, like, there's plenty of situations like it, you know, or like fucking Bjork. I remember the obsessive fan that was into Bjork. He was going to send a bomb to her house, blow her up, kill himself so they can meet in heaven. Fucking weirdo. And yet he wants to say there's nothing wrong. I'm like, man, get that shit out of here. You know, like, you gotta be fucking kidding me. Yes, there is something wrong being obsessed with music artists. You know, that... God, man. Like, it's just... This dude is irritating to watch, man. He's so just stupid. Like, God.
Picture to Burn. Picture to Burn is actually a very great song to listen to if you wanna just get shitty friends off your mind. And in my case, that would be Spear Dude, the Flamehead 97, TG Venom, and all those other people that have been spreading all this hate to me.
What's up, YouTube? This is your boy, Spear Dude 21, and I think it's now time for me to bury the shit out of Zachary G, the most hypocritical, fakest person that I've ever seen on the internet. There's just so many damn things wrong with this dude that it's not even funny. And if y'all haven't seen my other videos that I've made about Zachary G, then be sure to watch those videos first before you watch this one to fully understand the full history that I have with this dude. I destroyed Zachary in those videos. TG Venom destroyed him in some Facebook videos that he's made about him. Jackal Goldkick destroyed him in his Mr. Beef videos that he made about him. The Flamehead 97 destroyed him in the newest stream that he did on him. Kadeem the King destroyed him in his dissing videos on him. And I'm about to destroy him once again in this video. So first of all, I just want to say that I have a reason for making this video, because this dude has been making continuous videos bashing me, TG Venom, the Flamehead 97, and Jackal Goldkick. If he would have kept our names out his fucking mouth, then I wouldn't be doing this. But since he keeps talking all this shit about us like a little punk-ass bitch, I have to make this video to bury the hell out of him and expose him for all the BS that he's been doing. So this dude flip-flops all the fucking time. One minute he says he doesn't like Olivia Rodrigo and says she's a copycat. And then the next minute he says he likes her and denies the fact that she's a copycat. One minute he says he likes Machine Gun Kelly, and then the next minute he says he doesn't like him. One minute he says he likes Tupac, and then the next minute he says he doesn't like him. One minute he says he likes Michael Jackson, and then the next minute he says he doesn't like him. And he's also flip-flopped about shit tons of other artists.
I'm gonna be explaining why Billy Joel, the 70s rocker,
was right when he said that Taylor Swift is the Beatles of her generation.
Stop!
Is Taylor's lyrics, and it's not so much her lyrics and songwriting, it's more her success that makes her up there with the people like the Beatles, Michael Jackson, and, you know, all these older legends.
Bullshit, motherfucker!
Like I said before, the real definition of a copycat is someone who doesn't give the artist credit. Someone who has similarities of another person's music and doesn't give them credit. And someone who claims another artist's work as their own. But does Olivia do those things? Hell no, she doesn't. She doesn't do those things. So if Olivia gave credit, to Taylor and Paramore, that is what matters. It doesn't matter how many times she got called out, because people are still defending her to this very day, even months after it happened. I'm just trying to prove a point here. And no, just because Spear Dude showed proof in his video doesn't mean I have to agree to it.
And Zachary also says, "Oh, I have my reasons for flip-flopping." No you don't, motherfucker. No you don't, because normal people don't flip-flop as much as you do. It's either you like an artist or you don't like them. It's not hard at all for you to figure out if you like an artist or not. But the worst thing about Zach G is that he's way too fucking over-obsessed with Taylor Swift, to the point where he hates anybody who has a different opinion than him about Taylor Swift, even if the opinion is factual. I used to be a fan of Taylor Swift years ago, back in 2020 and the years before. And when I used to be a fan of hers, I heard every single one of her goddamn albums from start to finish. So I can say that it's a fact that she sings about the same old shit over and over and over again in most of her songs. She may have a few songs about some other stuff, but the majority of her music is about the same old shit over and over and over again. But apparently, this dude gets pissed off at me, TG Venom, and the Flamehead 97 when we say that Taylor Swift lacks topic variety and sings about the same old shit over and over and over again in most of her songs.
As of late, this fucker just keeps making various YouTube videos about me, Spear221, TG Venom, and Jocko Goldkick, and I've seriously had enough of the dude, so I want to call his bitch ass out and tell him to shut the fuck up. So, Zach G, I suggest you to shut the fuck up, quit bringing up old shit, because you're just making yourself look like a fucking dumbass. And you dare calling people haters just because they criticize Taylor Swift? Get the fuck out of here. Go fuck off. Leave the internet. No one wants you here. No one wants you here on YouTube, Zach G. All you do is run your mouth over and over and over. If you have such a problem with me, say it on Messenger and Instagram. Don't go say it on YouTube like a bitch, because you're just being a pussy and a coward. So I challenge you to join this live stream, because I have some words for you, but I know you won't join because you're a damn little bitch. You're a little bitch. You want to talk shit about me and other people on your stupid YouTube channel, but yet when you get confronted on Instagram and Messenger, you won't say shit, but block people and all that bullshit. So if you have such a problem with what I say about Taylor Swift, then fuck you! Because I don't give a fuck! Fuck you and fuck her! No one cares about her but you stupid stands. So I don't want to hear you saying, oh, flamehead this, flamehead that. Well, how about this, Zachary? Fuck you, fuck you, fuck you, and fuck you. Piece of shit. You wanna keep bringing up old shit? Well, I'm gonna destroy you because you're fucking with the wrong person when you fuck with me. I'm not gonna sit back any longer and let you talk shit about me. If you don't like my content, then quit watching it. Quit watching it. No one asked you, of all people, to make these videos. You're just doing it because you're a lowlife. You don't have anything else better to do in your little pathetic life. So you're going to take it out on me and other people. Over an opinion on Taylor Swift? Get the fuck out of here. Seriously. I challenge you to show up here because I'll roast you more and more. Don't believe me? Go ahead and find out. I'll destroy you once and for all. I've had enough of your shit, Zachary. So I, by demand, challenge you right fucking now. Come in here and talk shit. Talk shit. Talk shit. I don't care. Talk shit. You want to run your mouth, Zach? Fuck you. Shut the fuck up. No one asked for your fucking bullshit. Not me. Not Spearow, not TG Venom, not Jackal Goldkick. You want to fuck with us? You better shut your fucking mouth. You want to talk all that shit? Call me a hater. Fuck you. And you want to claim I haven't heard all of Taylor Swift's music? Fuck you for that too. Shove it up your fucking ass because I care less what you think about me, piece of shit. Seriously. Grow up. You're like 19 or 20 years old. You're acting like a damn 3-year-old. You go on people's YouTube channels, clicking on their old videos just so you can make your own little pathetic videos that no one's going to give a fuck about. You want to claim, oh, Olivia Rodrigo's not a copycat, this and that bullshit, when it's been proven time after time that she's a fucking copycat. So I don't want to hear your dumb excuses, little dude. Tired of you, Zachary. Grow up. You're like fucking 19 years old, 20 years old. Grow up, dude. Grow up for once in your life. You're the one that started it all, motherfucker. Lying piece of shit. Fuck you. Screw you. Chew on a dick, bitch. Run your mouth. Keep running it, Zachary. I challenge you. But I know you ain't gonna come on here because you're not man enough. You're not even man enough to read my messages on Messenger. But the only thing you're good at is talking that fucking trap here on YouTube. That's all you're good for. And anyone who agrees with you, they can fuck off too. I already know you got a little group of circle friends who are Taylor Swift fans just like you. But they're all toxic just like you. That's why they come on my YouTube videos talking shit. Because they agree with you, because they're delusional in the head just as much as you are, you fucking twat. You immature parasite. That's what you are. You're a fucking parasite. Had enough of you, Zachary. Read some of this chat, guys. Sorry about this. I'm just having to call him out because I'm tired of his bullshit.
If this dude was a mature, normal fan of Taylor Swift, then he would say, okay, I may be a fan of Taylor Swift, but even though I'm a fan of hers, I do admit that the majority of her music is about the same crap over and over and over again, which was the type of mindset that he had when he was cool with us, when he was cool with me, TG Venom, Jackal Goldkick, and the Flamehead 97. But now that he's no longer cool with us, he flip-flopped about his thoughts and said that we're wrong about what we say about Taylor. This dude is so mother effing obsessed with Taylor Swift to the point where he acts like Taylor Swift is better than Whitney Houston, Mariah Carey, Michael Jackson, Tupac, and all those other legends, which is a load of bullshit, because Taylor Swift ain't shit compared to those legends. I admit that years ago, from 2016 to 2019, I had a little obsession with Ariana Grande and Demi Lovato, but at least my obsession with them was very mild and wasn't very severe, to the point where I disrespect the old-school legends who are better than them. It was just a little obsession that I had with them, not a severe obsession like with Zachary with Taylor Swift. Zachary also disrespects the dead all the damn time, saying a bunch of negative shit and lies about Tupac, Michael Jackson, Whitney Houston, and Aaliyah, and denying their legacies, saying that they're not influential, and saying that Taylor Swift is better than them. Like... He also said that Taylor Swift is bigger and more successful than Whitney Houston and Michael Jackson, which is a load of bullshit. And here's the proof that it's a load of bullshit. So as y'all can see, Taylor Swift has sold 114 million records, whereas Whitney Houston has sold 200 million records, and Michael Jackson has sold 750 million records. So Zachary is full of crap for saying that Taylor Swift is bigger and more successful than real actual legends like Whitney Houston and Michael Jackson.
Yo, 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 what is up, everybody? This is Talking Ginger, and I am so glad that Spear Dude 21 is burying the shit out of Zachary G in this video. There's nothing legendary about Taylor Swift at all. Just because she has a lot of success and Grammy Awards, that doesn't make her a legend. So Zachary's argument about Taylor Swift being a legend because she has a lot of success and Grammy Awards is very fucking retarded, because Cardi B has a lot of success. Does that mean that Cardi B is a legend too? Fuck no, because she fucking sucks. And Zachary also lied about Tupac and Michael Jackson, saying that they aren't legends, claiming that Michael molested kids, and claiming that most of Tupac's music is about violence and gangs, which is a load of fucking bullshit, because Michael Jackson was innocent, and Spear Dude showed shit tons of real actual proof that he was innocent in the two videos that he made of him exposing the false allegations about him. And when it comes to Tupac, only some of his music was about violence and gangs. The majority of his music had messages behind them. So fuck Zachary for lying about dead people.
And then there's the whole Tupac thing, where Spear Dude disrespects opinions when people say, oh, what Tupac mainly talked about in the majority of his songs is his gang life, gang violence, and just all that graphic shit. You know, and that's not the only reason that I don't listen to Tupac anymore. That's one of the reasons, but the other reason is because he's just overrated. He's overrated as hell, man. He's overrated.
And then he says,
oh, it's Spear Dude, the Flamehead 97, Jackal Gold Kick, and TG Venom are hypocrites because they want me to respect their opinions on Taylor Swift, but they don't respect my opinions on Tupac and Michael Jackson.
Nigga, shut the fuck up.
Shut the fuck up.
Motherfucker, the difference is that Taylor Swift isn't dead, and our opinions on her have actual facts behind them. And we have the damn right to not respect your opinions about MJ and Tupac, because your opinions on them are very fucking disrespectful, and you lie about them all the fucking time. Even though they're dead and are no longer here to defend themselves. Disrespectful opinions about dead people do not deserve to be respected. And then he also said,
oh, Tupac is a hypocrite because in some of his songs he said he loved women, but in other songs he called them bitches and hoes.
Wow, really? Really? Zachary seriously said that stupid shit about Tupac? Spear Dude already made a fucking video about this. About Tupac explaining the differences between being a real woman and being a bitch and a hoe. And he showed a little clip in that video of Tupac explaining the differences between being a real woman and being a bitch and a hoe. He was not referring to all women in general as bitches and hoes when he mentioned them in some of his songs.
They're the ones that are shitty people, not me. I'm not the bad person. I'm just doing my thing and just speaking the truth about Taylor, since so many of her haters want to deny it. And another thing is, Taylor Swift she's had more Grammy Awards than most of these older artists that people like. More Grammy Awards than Michael Jackson, more Grammy Awards than Whitney Houston, more Grammy Awards than all these other older artists that people are fans of. An 11-time Grammy winning award winning songwriter. And I know I said this before, but Taylor Swift's lyrics are so influential that they're being taught in colleges, universities, and even grade school.
Oh my God, who the hell cares?
Is that happening with Whitney Houston? Is that happening with Tupac? Is that happening with Biggie, Eminem, Aaliyah, Michael Jackson, or any of those artists? No. Their lyrics weren't influential, and I'll tell you why. Tupac, he mainly rapped about, the majority of what he rapped about in his songs is his gang life.
Bullshit, motherfucker!
I know some people may get triggered at that, but it's the truth. And then, he may have a few songs like Dear Mama and Keep Your Head Up. But that doesn't mean he's this deep lyricist that everybody thinks he is. Just because you have a few songs that are deep, that doesn't make you a deep songwriter. Taylor Swift has more deep songs than this dude.
Bullshit, motherfucker!
So does Ariana Grande.
Bullshit, motherfucker!
So does Demi Lovato.
Bullshit, motherfucker!
What I really don't get about Tupac is that why does he say in one song that he likes women, but in another song he starts bashing them, calling them bitches, calling them skanks, calling them hoes? And it's like, you either have respect for women, or you don't have respect for women. And I've seen a clip that proves that he can't make up his mind about how he feels about women. One second he says he's for women, then the next second he says he's not for women.
Women like my sister, who I think represent a strong black woman, I did that. Now I'm rapping about the women that I see every day, and that was Get Around. If I just did songs like Keep Your Head Up, it would make me seem more than what I am, but I'm just a normal man.
America.
I like that. This is how it is.
But do you look down on your male friends if they're as promiscuous as some of the women in your songs?
I don't look down on anybody that's promiscuous. Only people I look down on are people who don't control the situation. I don't think like that, but I think that there are definitely a type of female, label them a bitch, who their main thing is just to get what they can get, and they revel in breaking a nigga's heart and taking what he owns.
Shut the fuck up!
There's male bitches too. I mean, women know that there are bitches out there. I don't know why women look surprised. They know. They say it louder. They just think that we're saying they're all bitches. That's not what we're saying.
I swear to God, it seems like Zachary doesn't pay attention to a damn thing that Speardude says in his videos. Because Speardude has literally debunked all the lies that he said about Tupac and Michael Jackson. And when it comes to Zachary talking shit about Tupac because he rapped about violence and gangs in some of his songs, he clearly doesn't even try to understand where Tupac was coming from when he made songs like that. Because everything Pac rapped about was based on real shit and real life issues. It is true that there's violence that happens in this world, and it is true that gangs exist in this world. He wasn't rapping about that kind of stuff to be negative. He rapped about it because it is shit that happens in real life, and to warn everybody about the harsh realities of this world. So fuck Zachary for spreading lies about dead people. That is so damn disrespectful, and proves that he's a complete heartless piece of shit for disrespecting the dead. Fuck him. Fuck him, fuck him, fuck him.
And then he also attacks people who believe that the Michael Jackson allegations about him being a pedophile are true. Now let me tell you something about these Michael Jackson allegations. You may think that these accusers, the courts, and the people who got molested by Michael Jackson, you may think that they just lied for money, but no. They were exposing him for being a child molester. They exposed him for doing that shit. And if Michael Jackson was so innocent, then why did he have to pay off the parents who demanded him money from the children that he molested? I've talked to a few Michael Jackson fans. I've talked to so many Michael Jackson fans that can actually admit that what he did was wrong, and they actually know the truth about the allegations. Hint, it's not the fact that he's innocent. He's not innocent. No matter how many times people try to say it, he's not. But the reality is, he was lying, and that's what you people need to realize. Quit listening to Spear, dude. That dude does not know what the hell he's talking about. He don't know shit. He just thinks that because there's clips of Michael Jackson talking about the allegations, he just thinks, oh, it's believable. No, you need to realize that he was ashamed of himself, and he was afraid to admit the truth.
And Brian, what do you want people to know now? Now that these pages, this investigation, all these investigations have been released, what do you want the public to know about it?
Very interesting, Robin, in all of these pages, hundreds of pages, many, many hours of investigation going to the Philippines, going to Chicago, going all over the country. There's not one scrap of evidence that Michael Jackson ever harmed a child, did anything wrong, committed any crime. It's almost a vindication when you look at this. The FBI looked at all of these matters and said, there's nothing here. And I think that's the most startling thing which I've seen.
But even though he talks about many different artists, people still stereotype this guy as this angry, bitter person who just rants on rap music. And let me explain why that's false. It's false because TG Venom, he likes many, many different kinds of music. Hell, he even listens to music that I've never even heard of, like a style of music called Baroque music. Well, yeah, let me explain why people who say that TG Venom rants, all he does is rant on mainstream rap music. Let me explain why that's false. He's made videos talking about Ariana Grande. He's made videos talking about Demi Lovato, Snoop Dogg, Michael Jackson, Prince, Madonna, Killswitch Engage, Whitney Houston, Taylor Swift, Olivia Rodrigo. He made a video talking about Machine Gun Kelly. He made actually two videos about it, talking about Machine Gun Kelly returning to rap and why Machine Gun Kelly was in the wrong to disrespect Slipknot like that. He's also made videos talking about different types of genres. He's talked about rock music, he's talked about metal, he's talked about horrorcore rap, he's talked about what else? He's talking about jazz, he's talking about country music. So no, he's not this damn angry, bitter person who just rants on hip-hop.
You don't have to like these artists, TG Venom, but to make rants on them and always be negative about it is just ridiculous. You don't always have to be negative. You could do what makes you happy. Don't worry about these music artists you don't like. Don't worry about criticizing artists, because it's just a waste of time. It's pointless. Like, why waste your time making videos on artists you don't like? The only reason is to be negative. There's even a video of him denying the fact that the Michael Jackson allegations are true, which is ridiculous, because Michael Jackson, he was a proven pedophile. There's no backing out of this.
Stop!
And to be honest, people claim that I disrespect him when I am actually not.
Bullshit, motherfucker!
It's like this dude and TG Venom, he also stole music from other people.
Bullshit, motherfucker!
I bet if Zachary was famous and people were spreading lies about him being a pedophile, he would be extremely upset and pissed off about that. So the fact that Zachary is spreading all these lies about MJ being a pedophile is very fucking sickening and twisted. Did he even watch the two videos I've made of me exposing the Michael Jackson pedophile allegations from start to finish? Because if he did, then he would know that I showed plenty of real actual proof that MJ was innocent. Zachary, you are lying about Michael Jackson and Tupac. You are trying to make them look bad, and I know it. Stop lying. You are not spreading the truth about them. You are trying to make them look bad. And I also showed real actual proof that Olivia Rodrigo is a copycat in the video that I've made of me exposing her. But apparently, he claims that me and TG Venom are delusional dumbasses for calling her a copycat, when in reality, he's the one who's a delusional dumbass, because he denies the fact that Olivia Rodrigo is a copycat, when there is tons of proof that she is. He denies the fact that Taylor Swift is overrated. He denies the fact that MJ was innocent. And he denies the fact that the majority of Pac's music had messages behind them. And then he lied about Whitney Houston and said that Whitney doesn't inspire pop singers and only inspires R&B singers, which is also complete bullshit, because Whitney has inspired many artists from all different types of genres. And he also said that Taylor Swift is better than Whitney Houston, which is also frickin' stupid and proves that he has no respect for legends at all.
Taylor Swift is better than Whitney Houston.
Bullshit, motherfucker!
The only singers I can really think of that really inspired, that Whitney really inspired, are that Whitney and Mariah really inspired, inspired are Ariana Grande and Rihanna. Because those two are R&B singers. The rest of these other singers, like Lady Gaga, Taylor Swift, Bebe Rexha, Katy Perry, Dua Lipa, and all these other pop singers, Madonna influenced them. So I think people need to really realize that Whitney just influenced R&B singers.
Bullshit, motherfucker!
And then he disrespected Aaliyah and denied her legacy just because she had ghostwriters.
You mean to tell me that Aaliyah is a legend? How? How is having ghostwriters legendary? How is not writing your own lyrics and having ghostwriters legendary? You know, that just doesn't make sense to me.
Wow, so Zachary talked shit about Aaliyah also, and denied her legacy just because she had ghostwriters. Aaliyah was a legend because the type of R&B music she was making at that time, back in the 90s, was different. And she inspired lots of other R&B singers, and paved the way for a lot of other R&B singers. Speardude also gave more reasons why Aaliyah was a legend in the two videos that he made about her. But it seems like Zachary never fucking listens. And another thing about Zachary is that he said that he hates Tupac, Biggie, and Eminem just because they're overrated, when he's obsessed with Taylor Swift and Olivia Rodrigo, who are also overrated. And when it comes to Taylor Swift is a lot more fucking overrated than Tupac and Biggie. Tupac has sold 75 million records, Biggie has sold 13 million records, and Taylor Swift has sold 114 million records. It's true that Eminem may be more overrated than Taylor Swift, since Eminem has sold 500 million records, and Taylor Swift has sold 114 million records. But Eminem is still a way better artist than Taylor Swift, based off his older music. But the fact that Zachary claimed that he hates Tupac, Biggie, and Eminem just because they're overrated is a very stupid-ass excuse to hate on an artist.
so retarded that Zachary tries to play victim and acts like me, TG Venom, Jackal Goldkick, and the Flamehead 97 treated him badly when it was him who treated us badly first. And TG Venom also told me that Zachary was trying to force him to like Taylor Swift and Olivia Rodrigo. But how can anybody take Zachary seriously when he literally flip-flops all the goddamn time? If you try to be friends with him, it is so damn hard to actually get to know him as a person or what his true thoughts on certain artists and other things are, since he flip-flops all the fucking time. Zachary G is literally the most fakest, most hypocritical, and most toxic person that I've ever came across on the internet. Even if you show him real actual proof that the stuff he's saying is not true, He doesn't believe it because he's so delusional and denies the truth when it's being spoken. If he tries to give me any more fake-ass apologies, I'm not giving him another chance because I already know that he's gonna continue to do the same old shit over and over and over again. I gave him many chances for him to redeem himself and change his ways, but he blew it every single damn time. So I'm done with his punk ass for good this time.
You're not supposed to hate on or dislike on Taylor Swift. I'm Zachary Gattuso, and you are not supposed to dislike Taylor Swift for any reason, you haters. This is Zachary Gattuso, not Andrew Mavidat. You're supposed to like Taylor Swift. You're supposed to.
Hello, everybody. This is Zachary Gattuso. And, I'm a freaking jackass because I'm going to destroy your opinions on Taylor Shizzle. And stop criticizing my opinions about Michael Jackson, Tupac, and Eminem, and Big Pun, and Whitney Houston, and shit like that!
That Brooklyn bullshit, we on it.
Baby, can't you see? Sometimes your words just hypnotize me. And I just love your flashy ways. Guess that's why they're broken, you're so petty. Baby, can't you see?